In this video, we're going to take a look at two other kinds of relationships. And these two other kinds do not exist in the database that we are about to work on and put together. I only want to mention all four kinds of relationships right away, just so you know that these all exist. So the other two important relationships you need to understand are the many-to-many and the one-to-one. We're going to take a look at a couple of examples on these, and then go through a quick quiz, and we will see examples of these kinds of relationships later on inside the course. Okay, so let's get to it. So these are all examples of one-to-one relationships. In a one-to-one relationship, there is exactly one record that has a relationship to exactly one other record. And the opposite is true as well. Now, when I describe that with words, it doesn't make a lot of sense. Let's just take a look at a couple of examples, and I think you'll get the idea of a one-to-one relationship rather quickly. The first example we might consider is boats related to captains. A boat only has one captain at any given time, and likewise, a captain is only the captain of one boat at a time. Now, I'm sure in the world you can possibly imagine that maybe there's some captain who was the captain of two boats at the same time, but again, we can kind of generalize this and just assume in general that maybe one boat has one captain and one captain has one boat. Likewise, a company might have only one CEO at a given time, and a CEO might only be the CEO for one single company. Again, I'm sure you could think of exceptions to this. There are definitely companies out there that have multiple different CEOs, and maybe a given CEO works for many different companies, but whatever, we can just assume, just for the purposes of this discussion, that a company has one CEO and a CEO has one company. Now, this is a pretty good example right here, capitals and countries. As far as I'm aware, there are no capitals or cities in the world that serve as the capital for many different countries at the same time. So we would say that a capital has one country, and a country has one capital. Students and desks. So in general, a student will sit at one desk, and a desk will seat one student at a time. And then finally, a person and a driver's license or some kind of identifying card or identification papers. A person probably only has one driver's license at a time, and that driver's license is intended for one single person. If I have a driver's license, I can't give it to you and have it work for you. The driver's license has my name on it, so it's intended to be a driver's license just for me and nobody else. Okay, so that's some examples of one-to-one relationships. Now, just one other kind of relationship that we're going to consider, that is a many-to-many. Now, this is where it gets a little bit trickier, but I'm sure you can still kind of understand this for right now. And again, we will see a practical implementation of many-to-many later on in the course. So a couple examples here as well. We might say that there are many students at a school, and all these students probably go to a variety of different classes over the span of a day or a week or something like that. Likewise, each of those classes have many students inside them. So we would say that a student has many classes, and a class has many students. How about tasks and engineers? If you consider a task or something to be done at a large software engineering company, there might be multiple engineers who are assigned to one task or maybe one project. And at the same time, a single engineer might be assigned to multiple different tasks. So a task has many engineers working on it, and an engineer might be working on many different tasks. Sports games is another great example here. So there might be many different players who play in a single football match. And there are many matches, or there are matches that have many players playing in them. Movies is another great example. So there are many movies that have been created in the world. The majority of movies probably have multiple different actors or actresses starring in them. And a given actor or actress might star in many different movies. And then finally, conference calls. Now this is a little bit trickier because in this case, we're kind of considering the case of a long duration of time. So maybe over the span of 1 week, there might be many conference calls that have many different employees on them. And over the span of 1 week, there might be an employee that is in many different conference calls. Now again, I kind of stress that time is a factor in this relationship. Because if we consider maybe just at this moment in time, well, maybe at a single instant in time, an employee is only in one conference call at a time. So we might say that over the span of a week, an employee will be in many different conference calls. All right, so again, these are all examples of one-to-one relationships and many-to-many relationships. We are going to see practical examples of these relationships later on inside the course, but for the database that we're working on right now, we're just going to be concerned with one-to-many and many-to-one. So at this point, we have examples or kind of an idea of what these four different kinds of relationships are, but we have no idea how to actually reflect or store information tying these records together inside of our database. That's the part that we're missing. So let's take a look at another couple diagrams in the next video and understand how we actually set up a one-to-many or a many-to-one relationship.